of change of class. Lenz's law says, no, this fellow is opposing, you have to add one minus. So this equation is combination of Lenz's law and Faraday's. Third Maxwell's equation, third derivation, EMF minus d phi by dt. When I have a single variable, I can write it as minus dou phi by dou t. Divide by area on both sides. So if I divide by area on both sides, work done by area is minus dou by dou t of flux by area. Flux by area is flux density. Work done by area is defined as curl E. Curl E is minus dou B by dou t. I have taken Faraday's law, I have divided on both sides by area. Left hand side I am getting curl E. Curl E is work done by area. Right hand side flux by area is flux density. So curl E is minus dou B by dou t. This equation is called field form of Faraday's law. Maxwell was very happy. He has seen an equation which relates magnetic field and electric field. Left hand side you have electric field, right hand side you have magnetic. So he made a statement, a time varying magnetic field will produce electric field. A time varying magnetic field will produce electric field. Faraday said in a simple language, a time varying magnetic flux will produce voltage. Voltage divided by distance is electric field. So this man says a time varying magnetic field will produce electric. So dynamic EMF, so what do you mean by dynamically induced EMF? What is statically induced EMF? What is dynamically induced EMF? In a transformer you have static EMF. In a transformer coil is taking rest, coil is stationary, flux is changing with time, an EMF is induced, that is statically induced. In a generator or in a dynamo the flux is stationary and the conductor is moving. So if the flux is stationary and conductor is moving, an EMF is induced, that EMF is dynamically induced EMF. Example, your cycle dynamo. Faraday says three conditions are required to produce electricity. There should be conductor, there should be magnetic flux and mechanical force. If all the three are there, magnetic flux, conductor and mechanical force, then EMF will be produced. Example, your cycle dynamo. The faster you ride the cycle, brighter the lamp. The slower you ride the cycle, dimmer the lamp. Because once you ride the cycle faster, velocity is higher. If velocity is higher, EMF is higher. Brightness is higher. If you don't drive the cycle, if you don't apply force, if you don't drive the cycle, velocity is zero, EMF is zero. Faraday's homopolar generator or Faraday disc generator, very first kind of generator Faraday has developed. So Faraday was playing with a copper disc. He has taken a copper disc, he was playing, he has connected a bulb between the disc and the shaft. Suddenly the bulb was glowing. Faraday has taken a copper disc, he was rotating this. He has connected a bulb between the disc and the shaft and the bulb was glowing. Then he got the idea, why not I put more disc and get more voltage. That is how he has developed generator. So very first kind of generator developed by Faraday had only one disc. With one disc he got less voltage, then you put more and more number of discs, you can get higher amount of. So last equation, fourth Maxwell's equation, very important equation, fourth derivation. Because when Maxwell was deriving fourth equation, he has invented a concept called displacement current. So tell me, what is displacement current? Conduction current, I told you. Conduction current is due to free charges. You take a capacitor, apply AC voltage, connect an ammeter, what do you find? Take your fan capacitor, apply AC voltage, connect an ammeter, you find some deflection. How? In the parallel plate capacitor, there are two plates are there. Between the plates, dielectric is there. an insulator is there, but when I connect an ammeter, it is showing deflection. So Maxwell named that current as displacement current. Current through the capacitor is called displacement. There are two interesting questions. In a long transmission line, if receiving end current is 100 ampere, sending end current is 200 amperes. In a long cable, if receiving end current is 100 ampere, sending end current is 1000 amperes. So Maxwell got puzzled. How come when receiving end current is 100 ampere, sending end current is 1000 ampere? Throughout the line or throughout the cable, you have capacitance. Between the conductor and the ground, capacitance is there. That capacitance is drawing current. If I add all these currents with my useful current, then I get the total current. So total current at the sending end is sum of the useful receiving end current plus useless charging current. The charging current, he called it as displacement. So Maxwell has given an answer why sending end current is much larger than the receiving end current, because throughout the line capacitance is there and this capacitance is drawing current. So Maxwell has modified the Ampere's law. Basic Ampere's law says work done equal to conduction current, but he said you also have to consider displacement. So work done is sum of conduction current and displacement current divided by small area. Work done by area is called H. I by delta S is conduction current density. I D by delta S is displacement current density. So called H is J plus JD. This is called field form of modified Ampere's law. Basic Ampere's law says curl H equal to J. Modified Ampere's law says curl H equal to J plus J. Don't forget the JD. In AC circuits, charging current is there. So for DC circuits, basic Ampere's law is okay. But in AC circuits, you also have charging current. So you have to add the effect of displacement current. So in conductors, conduction current will be very large. Displacement current is negligible. In capacitors, displacement current will be very large and conduction current will be negligible. What is wave? Then we will see what is plane wave. What is wave? Maybe if I ask Rajini wave and Kamal Hassan wave, you will tell. Vishwarupam is a hit movie, somebody says in Mumbai. Same thing they say in Bangalore, same thing they say in Chennai. So there is something happened at Mumbai, same thing has propagated to Chennai and different places. So something happens at one point and same thing happens at different points, that phenomena is wave. So if you are sitting on the beach and then watching the waves, the wave will appear, crest of the wave will appear here, after some time it will appear here, after some time it will appear. And distance between two adjacent crests is defined as? Distance between two adjacent peaks is defined as wavelength. So wave is a phenomena which appears at one point and the same thing will be repeating at subsequent. So plane wave means E and H are perpendicular, everywhere E and H are uniform. The ratio of E to H gives surge impedance. The ratio of E to H gives surge impedance. Unit of E volts per meter, unit of H amps per meter. So what is volts per meter by amps per meter? What is volts per meter by amps per meter? Ohms. That is surge impedance. So this is your electromagnetic equation. This is your wave equation. This electromagnetic wave equation you get in here. Wave equation you get in physics. You compare these two. If you compare these two, you get V square is 1 by mu epsilon. V is 1 by root of mu epsilon. If I simplify this, V is 3 into 10 to the power 8 by root of mu r epsilon. So if I take air, for air mu r is 1, epsilon r is 1, velocity is 3 to 10 to power 8 meters per second. Electromagnetic waves travel with the velocity of light, 3 into 10 to power 8 meters per second. I am going to answer the question what I asked you in the beginning. You are singing in Chennai and your friend in Madurai is able to listen to your song almost instantaneously because electromagnetic waves travel with the velocity of 3 into 10 to power 8. So velocity is 3 into 10 to power 8, distance 3 into 300 kilometers. Then you find out the time. So time will be of the order of microseconds. So for the electromagnetic wave to start from Chennai and reach, it will take microseconds. So within microseconds, the wave can reach the receiver. And the medium is rest medium. God has created rest medium. You take any other medium. You take iron. For iron, the mu r is 1000. So 3 into 10 power 8 divided by root of 1000 into epsilon for velocity gets reduced. You take some mica or wood. If you take mica or wood, the epsilon r is 10. So any medium velocity is less, but in air velocity is maximum. God has created naturally air, and to air electromagnetic waves will be traveling with very high velocity. Then I am coming to the second question. At Neyveli you have a generator. The switch at Neyveli is closed and the lamp in Chennai is on. Electromagnetic waves will be traveling over the conductor. Very quickly there is the receiving end and the energy comes through the electromagnetic waves and the load at the receiving end will be energized. You should not think that an electron starts from Neyveli and the light will travel slowly and comes to Chennai and hence the lamp is on, the conductor is not there. The conductor is a guide. The conductor is a guide. Earth is the guide. Snake is moving on the earth. Like the conductor is a guide. Over the conductor, like a snake, electromagnetic wave is a fast moving snake which moves with a velocity of 3 to 10 power 8 meters per second. Volume. So you divide energy by volume, you get energy density. Then we have to talk about Poynting vector. Poynting vector, the concept of Poynting vector is developed to explain the flow of energy in dielectrics. Take the example of radio transmitter, receiver system. Between transmitter and receiver, we are saying energy is flowing. Energy is flowing through air. Air is a dielectric. To explain the concept of energy that is flowing through air, a concept called the Poynting vector is developed. So Poynting vector is defined as E cross H. So we said E and H are perpendicular. So S is E H sine 90. Electric field voltage by distance, H is I by 2 pi r. Numerator is power, denominator is area. So Poynting vector is called power density vector. Power by area is? Power by area is? Power density. So E cross H, it gives you power. If I take a transmission line, in the transmission line of the charge I have given at the sending end, electric field is there. So in a transmission line, the electric field and magnetic field are perpendicular. So if electric field and magnetic field are perpendicular, then energy will be flowing in a direction perpendicular to this. What is the meaning of S equal to E cross H? S gives n cap. A n cap is a unit vector perpendicular to E and H. So if magnetic field is like this and electric field is like this, then energy will be perpendicular to this. In a transmission line, electric field is there, magnetic field is there, and energy is moving in a direction perpendicular to E and H. So there is a theorem called Poynting's theorem. At the sending end, you have transmitter. At the sending end, you have transmitter. So in the transmitter, energy is released. The transmitter is generating energy that is given to the space. In the space, some energy is stored and remaining energy will be going out. Similar to your human body. Human body, every day you are taking some food. Entire energy is not converted into useful energy. Some energy is stored in your body in the form of fats. So if you take some food every day, A part of the energy is stored in your body and remaining energy is coming out. That's what Poynting theorem says. So Poynting theorem says at the sending end, you have got some power that is coming inside. Partly it is stored in magnetic field and electric field. Remaining power will be coming out. So power input is equal to the power stored plus the power coming out. Our energy input is equal to energy stored plus the energy coming out. So how to harness the energy? Energy is there in coal, energy is there in petrol, energy is there in diesel, energy is there in electromagnetic wave. So if you want to harness the energy, you put lot of antennas on top of your house. On top of your house, you put lot of TV antennas. Every antenna is linking with the electromagnetic waves and an EMF is induced. Connect all the antennas in series, all the voltages will get added. You get significant AC voltage. Then you give it to your rectifier, convert the AC into DC. Use the DC for charging the batteries in your house. You may have some small batteries to be used in your clock and all that, rechargeable batteries. So if you have rechargeable batteries at the home, then you try to charge them from the energy. So electromagnetic energy is available, you can harness that. You are collecting the energy from the sun using solar cell. You are collecting the energy from the water using hydro plant. You are collecting the energy from coal by using thermal plant. You can collect the energy from the electromagnetic waves by using this IP. Then we also have to talk about electromagnetic pollution or EMI. What is EMI? Today's biggest problem. Once upon a time we were worried about noise pollution and smoke pollution.